Monday, and winning in tennis player Simona Halep made it to the second leg. Romanian Foreign Minister Bogdan Aurescu attended in Brussels on Monday the proceedings of the Foreign Affairs Council alongside his. At the meeting, he stressed the need for a strategic expansion in relation with Russia and pleaded for maintaining the sanctions against that country. He also highlighted the impact of Russia's actions in Ukraine on the security situation in the region and the importance of a good coordination with NATO and the United States. The EU Foreign Minister has also expressed his support on terrorism against the brunt of the recent attacks in France, the Middle East, Greece, and climate change. Also in Brussels on Monday, Romanian Justice Minister Robert Kazanciuk met with the first Vice President of the European Commission, Franz Timmermans, and the Commissioner for Justice, Consumers and Gender Equality, Vera Jourova. According to a communique issued by the Justice Ministry in Bucharest, Kazanciuk presented the progress made by Romania under the preparation and verification mechanism and stressed the national authorities' determination to carry on the reform of the judiciary and the fight against corruption. Also, he reiterated Romanian government's wish to support the judiciary in implementing the new code. In turn, European officials appreciated the reforms implemented by Romania. Reform of the Romanian justice system have been monitored under the cooperation and verification mechanism since 2006. Kiev is willing to cooperate with Moscow in order to ensure the ceasefire in eastern Ukraine, said on Monday the Ukrainian Foreign Minister Kiev. On Sunday, the Kremlin stated that Kiev authorities had rejected the plan proposed by the Russian President Vladimir Putin regarding the pullout of heavy artillery from the front line. On the ground, the Ukrainian army and the pro-Russian separatists carry on violent fighting on the ruins of the Donetsk airport. Since April 2014, 4,800 people, both soldiers and civilians, have been killed in clashes between the Ukrainian army and separatists. U.S. President Barack Obama, on Tuesday, in his State of the Nation speech, will propose several domestic policy projects, among which increasing taxes for the rich and fiscal incentives for the middle class. Obama has already made public some of the themes of his speech during visits to various cities in the United States and on social networks. According to American political analysts, the proposals show the president's intention as to his legacy to the people and shape up economic agenda for the next presidential election campaign. President Obama plans to use the last 2 years of his term to extend federal authority, analysts also say. For 26 years now, Romania's population has been dropping, announced on Monday the Vladimir Tribut Institute for Democratic Research of the Romanian Academy. According to the director of the institute, Vasile Ghisu, Romania's population is now less than 20 million. In 1990, right after the fall of the communist regime, Romania's population stood at 23.2 million. He has also said that this drop is the big extraction of the sustainability of the public pension system. A new week of prayer for Christian unity started in Bucharest on Monday. According to a communique issued by the Patriarchy of the Romanian Orthodox Church, every year over the third week of January, priests and believers belonging to various Christian churches pray together, each evening in a different place of worship. In Bucharest, the week of prayer started at the Orthodox Patriarchy and continues with the Reformed, Calvinist, Greek Catholic, Lutheran and Armenian churches to end on January 26th at the Roman Catholic Church. In our sports, the city of Melbourne this week is hosting the Australian International Tennis Tournament, which has had as participants the world's third-ranked Romanian Simona Halep. The Romanian tennis player qualified on Thursday after beating Italian Karin Knapp in two sets, 6-3, 6-2. Another Romanian player, Irina Begu, has got a surprising result in this tournament, a three-set win against ninth-seeded Angelique Kerber of Germany. Romanian Foreign and Justice Ministers, Bogdan Aurescu and Robert Kazanciuk, respectively, had meetings in Brussels with EU officials. Romania's population has been dropping for 26 years now. A new week of prayer for sporting unity started in Bucharest, and Romanian tennis player Simona Halep made it to the second leg of the Australian Open.